So as a collective, we're from Boone, North Carolina. I think something that's big in Boone is a sense of community. It's kind of an isolated mountain town, so it's like there's a lot that's unique there that kind of just flourishes because you only have like a limited amount of space that you're working with to interact with folks, and so it just kind of draws everybody together a little bit more, and you end up bonding maybe with people that you wouldn't normally in a, like a larger city end up like bonding with. We definitely had like different music tastes and all kinds of stuff, but just like by the nature of it, we just happened to be so lucky to end up together, you know? Mm-hmm. Music was everything in a sense, and also kind of a dream not to be hoped for, like in terms of like success. We made a promise like when we started this, basically that we were not gonna get that big. You know what I mean? Like we weren't gonna chase the dream. Yeah, school came first and other passions and pursuits. Like we were just gonna just have fun with it, you know? And that's, I think that saved us.
I mean, the pandemic was really hard on us as musicians. I mean, in a lot of ways, but just being able to be back and like be on the road together and share our music with the fans, like literally be in the same room and have that connection, it was something that was really hard not to have.
Yeah, you definitely don't realize what you got till it's gone kind of thing, you know?
After going through all that time alone, like dark times, but like finding your way out and like having that space to like settle into your own energy and like understand what we're doing in a bigger perspective. I like slowing down was good, even as bad as everything was.
I think we grew as musicians, as matured as people, and
yeah,
it was a long 2 years.
The music itself has evolved over the time that we've been playing it, and what it means in our lives and what it means to play it for people has changed in a way that's like just growing every day, you know? Me personally, it just means more and more every time we do a show to like share that with people. So we've been working with Plus One for a few years now. Just in April alone, we've raised $25,000 for local food banks. So like every time we play a show in a city, the money that we raise from Plus One, which is like a dollar added on every ticket, goes to food banks in that area. We've also been working with them to donate to Quality NC when we were in North Carolina, to groups like Appalachian Outreach and Tennessee Equality Project, both advocacy groups and groups that are more geared towards care and outreach and that type of thing for LGBTQ+ groups. Yeah. We live in Tennessee, which is kind of a middling state in terms of like the way LGBTQ+ folks are treated. I mean, there's definitely some areas that need a lot of work.
It's important because like that's kind of like the narrative that sometimes gets like pushed onto LGBTQ people in our area. It's like,
yeah,
go to LA, go to New York, get out of here,
yeah,
you know?
Right,
and it's like,
right, yeah, and some folks can't do
like,
that.
Like, yeah, to stay at home and show the people and the youths that, like, mm-hmm, it's that like you can be Southern and queer,
yeah,
and proud both.
It's okay to be who you are, yeah.
Well, there's two sides to my taillights, and they both don't work right. And there's a motel on the highway, 100 miles outside. Let it out below. When I'm next to you, I could wave to you, because we're miles apart. Where you roll me, about you change things, but baby, you know me. I don't read a damn thing. Don't ever read a damn thing. Well, the first cut was the deepest, but it healed a hole. And the last one was a clean hit, but I bled out below. We were a team, till you're toxic. I mean, you talk shit often. But once upon a time, we were in love. No, there's two lanes on a highway, and I passed you by.